Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and I'm so happy to be back again with another episode. Today I'm going to be sharing about something that has been bothering my mind and something that is very vital that we should reflect on and we should think about it. And I know some of you will be like, oh, why is she picking up sides and why is she saying those things? And you come to understand the reason why I'm saying this, because I've thought so much about it and I thought so much about it, and I realized that why should I not, you know, why should I not continue to love one another? And we all know there's been a lot of videos and a lot of pictures have been going viral on the internet regarding our loved one. When I'm talking about love, I'm talking about the body of Christ. It's so sad that when people are looking at Christianity, they think it's just one of those things, like, oh, one of those religious. Christianity is more than a religious. It's the way of life. It's our everyday life, the way we live our life. That's Christianity on its own. So for me, when you see a lot of videos, a lot of pictures that it looks not nice to be shared across amongst people, even those people that are unbelieved, that they don't believe, then when they see those things, even though they wanted to believe in the word of God, their faith is gonna be, you know, a bit down. They'll be like, oh, why should I go to church? Why should I do this? But my question to you is, as a body of Christ, if your leg or your hand is hurting, and if you have a cut in your hand, or like a big massive cut in your hand and or on your leg, and would you pretend that it's just normal and you're gonna go day by days with that? I don't think so. It's just when you see our brothers or sisters that they are falling and they have done something that is not good, we should not be the first people to throw stone at them. We shouldn't be the first people to be pointing finger at them. Just as we did something, we want people to continue to show us love and support us and show us the way. So when I was seeing those pictures and sharing, I started to think, I'm like, why are we not loving one another? Why are we not praying for one another? When you see your body's falling, your body is doing something that is not right, you should continue to show love to them. Because, you know, one thing, even though they're singers, they're singing for God, they are doing things for God, that one thing, that the gift of God, you never want to take away from them. You know, you never want to take away from them. And if I'll share this scripture to you, which is very vital, and then I know that you'll be blessed with this. Say, for the gift and his calls can never be withdrawn. He has called them, just the way God has called us, to reach out to one another. You know, to reach out to a loved one. So you need to be able, like, if you're seeing this kind of thing, you should be able to say, I don't want to see it. And you should be able to encourage their brother who's willing to share those videos, to say, you know what, we should not share those videos. What we should do, to pray for them, to strengthen them, that they should come back in the path of the word of God, that they should come back to reach out to God and continue to do the work of God. Not to be, you know, condemn them, to tell them this, you know, to put them into shame. Like I said, if your leg was hurting, you want to go to the hospital to get treated and to get all that you can so you can feel better. It's the same thing as your brother who has fallen. As a brother keeper, you go close to them and share the word of God to them, reach out to them, pray with them, strengthen them, so when they're coming back, they're coming even more strong than they was before. And there's another Bible verse, that a woman who was a prostitute in the Bible, and that they were literally condemning her. Everything, like, she's a bad person because she sleeps with men and everything. And they kept questioning Jesus in the Bible. And John, that's the verse, is John 8:7. And it says, let any one of you whose without sin be the first to throw a stone at her. We all sin in different ways. We all do things in different ways. But God and His love and His compassion, He continues to love us. He continues to share us the love of Christ. He continues, as many times we keep him falling, as many times we keep picking us up. Even as your brother, if they are falling, you go on your knee and pray for them. Pray for your sister. Pray for your brother, even your loved one. Pray for them, saying, you know what? I want them to be continue to seek you. I want them to continue to reach out to you, O Lord. Strengthen them, because we are in a journey, and this journey is going to be a lot of things that will be missing on our way, a lot of things that will take us away from the focus of the Word of God. But as one another, we'll continue to strengthen each other in the body of Christ. We continue to help each other. As you continue, you know, like your leg, you continue to help your leg to be strengthened. You every day you take one step at a time. You take one step at two, you start walking again as normal. It's just as our brothers, we'll continue to help them, to reach out to them. Reach out to them. Love them. Just the way God loves you. He loves you so much that He sent His only begotten Son to come and die for you. That's the same love that you should share with the one that has fallen. You know, it was a burden to my heart. And I wanted us to take a moment of reflection, to reflect upon this subject. Let not be a laughing matter. Let when you see those things, you pray. You look up to Him, you pray for those ones. You know, it is there's a story in the Bible that the son who went away from his father, and he went away for a long time. He didn't want nothing to do with his father. But the day he came back, they did a party for them. For him, it was a big party. Just the way, if your brother has gone away from the Word of God, when they will come back, celebrate. Don't remind them of what they have done, because so many things that you have done, nobody has looked into it, even the Heavenly Father. So I wanted to share this to you. It cannot be those ones we know, but it's also those ones we don't know. Those brothers that come to church, that you see them every single time, you haven't seen them for ages. Reach out to them. Find out what is going on. Love them. So, and I wish you all a happy week as reflecting on this message. And I know if you have any question, anything regarding this topic, please share it on the below, and I would love to share with you. Just a quick one as well, everyone. I'm just giving this book for free, a free copy if you're interested. And it's The Power of Your Mind. And this book is really good, and it's been written by Pastor Chris. And it has blessed me for so many years, and I would like to bless you with this copy. And if you like the copy of this book, please reach out to me. Just drop me a message on the below, and I'll be able to give you a free copy of this book. Take care. Bye.